Hey, Bookish Babe, and welcome to my Book Nook. For those that are new around here, the name's Rainey. I teach music and I also read tons of books, thriller, horror, sci-fi, fantasy, romance, nonfiction, all the different types of genres. So if you're interested in that, please like and subscribe down to my channel down below. It really helps my channel grow. And you can also follow me on all my social media handles. I'm Rainey Blue Reads across the board. So today's video is going to be a mixture of a weekly vlog and the start of a new series on my channel called Series Declutter. One of my recent videos was where I literally went through my entire spreadsheet of series that I own, or I've started, or I'm somewhere in the process of. And I told you how I wanted to get that number down to where I have less series that I'm in the middle of. So this is a continuation onto that. In episode 2, if you will, where I'm going to start decluttering my series by reading and finishing series. So sometimes in these videos, I will be starting the very first book and finishing the entire series in the vlog. Sometimes I'll be starting from where I'm at in the series and finishing until wherever they are at, whether it's a completed series or not. And so that's gonna be the theme of this, hence series declutter. And so I'm sure you're wondering by now, which series are you going to see me eat up during this weekly vlog? And that would be the Caraval series by Stephanie Garber. Now, I have a reason as to why I'm reading that, because I want to read the Once Upon a Broken Heart trilogy by her. However, I heard that it takes place in the same universe as this, and I put a poll up on Instagram, and half of the people said, yeah, you should read this first, or you should read the Caraval series first, because it's interconnected enough. And half of the people said, no, you can go into this alone. But you know what? I didn't want to listen to those people. I want to be able to finish all of these, including these. So this will be a separate video where I read the third book as well. I want to be done by October so I can read A Curse for True Love in real time with everybody else, because I've heard everybody loves this series way more than the Caraval series. And so I want to get to this. So that's the main reason we're doing this vlog. But in this vlog, you will see me read Caraval, which is the first book, Legendary, which is the second book, and Finale. And so I'm very excited to be starting and finishing this series. I've been wanting to read this series for a long time and I just haven't prioritized it. As of right now, I'm already 50% into Caraval. You'll see my update on that super soon. And I'm not gonna explain what it's about because I say in the next part of the clip that I feel like part of the synopsis is a spoiler because it didn't happen until about 25% in. And I feel like if it hasn't happened before 20%, it's kind of spoilery, but that's just how I feel. So I will tell you what it's about in the next clip. But hopefully I love this series and then we can watch me tick it off of the series chart. I mean, that is the whole purpose of this video. On to reading. Good morning, vloggy vlog. It is the next day and I have exciting things to share with you. Well, it's actually Sunday, but for those of you who don't know, I am currently on a Cassandra Clare book buying journey. I want to read the whole Shadowhunter series universe. I know there's like 500 books. It is what it is. Well, I happened to walk into my local bookstore the other day and they had the entire Dark Artifices hardcover series and each of these books was like $6 to $10. So I got the three books in the Dark Artifices trilogy for about $25, which is really awesome because these books are massive and it's the old covers, although I don't think they have new covers for this yet. Yes, yet. I am trying to collect all the old covers because I have the old covers of the Mortal Instruments. I still need books 5 and 6, but that was very exciting. And then, of course, I bought some books that are on their way to me right now. I have Even If It Hurts by Marnie Mann on its way to me. I have The Heir, which is the first book in the Kingmaker series by Sophie Lark, the original Hot Guy cover on its way to me because I am trying to collect all of Sophie Lark's books. And then I also have Juniper Hill, Garnet Flats, and Jasper Vale. The next three books in the Edens series, so this is the first book, let me grab it, by Devney Perry, which I read this, a romantic suspense, gave it 4.5 stars. I really liked it, so I'm trying to collect that, and this one person was selling each book for like $5. Had to buy it. And you know what? I'm not gonna feel bad because it's like summer. I can buy books. Also, it's almost my birthday. I can also buy books. Also, if you want to buy me a book for my birthday, my wish list is always down below here. You don't have to. I'd love you, but you don't have to. Anyway, I don't need more books in all honesty. Actually, that's a lie. You can never have too many books. I agree with what my mom said. My husband may see differently, but I don't see differently. So anyway, those are books that I bought because I have a book buying problem. And that is a different thing than a book reading problem. They're different things. But outside of that, today is going to be very chill. It's Sunday. I'm just hanging out with the babes. They're both asleep right now, thank God, because I needed a break, especially after last night. If you saw last week's vlog, then you know that my son was giving me a lot of trouble and stayed up till like 1 in the morning, so I'm kind of tired. But I gotta get up when they're asleep. got to get shit done. Oh, I feel so alive. As I reach out to the sky. I found my way. I was in the dark. Hello friends. Sorry if you hear the TV in the background. I have baby girl up here on the table with me doing an update from here. I have my son and his Wendy's and him, he's drawing some markers. So I turned the TV down a little bit for this update. I am 50% into Caraval. I was going to update last night and I just didn't. I am really liking this. I don't even know if I said what this is about. However, there is something in the synopsis that I read that doesn't really happen until at least 25% into the book. And I feel like if you're not going to reveal it before 10%, then maybe it shouldn't be in the synopsis. So I'm going to say the synopsis. If you don't want to hear the synopsis and you want to go in blind, I'll put up like synopsis spoiler alert here. And then when I'm done, you can tune back in. But what it's about is these two sisters named Donatella and Scarlett. And they live in like this Meridian Isles or something. And basically they have both been promised off for arranged marriages in the future. And Scarlett's wedding is up soon. And this boy named Julian, this sailor, comes through and he's flirting with Donatella. And for 7 years before that, Scarlett had been wanting to go to this mystery land called Caraval and like meet Legend. Like it's like a band or something, or I'm not entirely sure what Caraval is. But she's been writing letters to him every single year and he hasn't responded until finally, when she's getting married, he says, I would love for you and your fiance to come to Caraval, free tickets, here you go. So she gets 3 tickets. And she, the sailor comes by and says, I can take you there because it's in 3 days. And she said, well, my wedding's in 6 days. I can't go, whatever. And so they end up deciding to go anyway, because their father is crazy and she doesn't want to actually marry this man. And her sister kind of kidnaps her and makes her go because she wants to go. Anyway, the plot point that they didn't say, or they say, is that Donatella is the reason that they are going to this games, because the games always revolve around finding something. And this year, Legend thought it would be fun to kidnap Donatella and make everyone have to find her. So that's why he wanted Scarlett and her fiance. Although her fiance doesn't go, Julian goes, pretends to be her fiance, the sailor dude. So anyway, they didn't reveal that Donatella was the one that they're looking for until 25% in. So I feel like that's a little bit of a spoiler. But it is what it is. And so this whole story revolves around the 5 days and nights of Caraval, the game itself, and all these clues that you have to find in order to find the person. And they don't know what's going to happen if they don't find Donatella before the end. So we are currently on day 4, because something interesting just happened on day 2, and so we flash forward to day 4. And I can tell that Julian is going to be the love interest in this. And I like it so far. I don't think it's very strong in the buildup of like the sister relationship. And I think you're really supposed to care about the sisters, but we didn't have enough buildup with them prior because like she left like 5% into the book. But I'm still really enjoying it. I feel like it's going to be a 3.75, maybe a 4 by the end of this. I'm having a fun time. So hopefully I will get to the 75% mark tonight, because I do have to finish the 3 books this week. And then I need to start the Once Upon a Broken Heart series so that I can catch up to that by October, because I really just want to be caught up and read that when everybody else is, because everybody says that series is great. And everybody voted in my poll on Instagram. Half the people voted that I didn't have to read these first. Half said I should, because they're interconnected. And I'm all about an interconnected land. So I will catch up with you later. Baby girl needs to work on her rolling. So that's where we're at with that. Oh, I feel so alive. As I reach out to the sky. I found my way. I was in the dark against it all, but made it through the day. Cause I found my way. In bad times, I know I'll be okay, 'cause I found my way. Okay, friend, you're propped up while I'm waiting for Zaxby's, because that is what our life has come to while I don't have my son. I don't have my son from today at noon to tomorrow at 2, because he's with Grandma, and it's a fabulous day. So I'm going to get a lot of reading done and a lot of other stuff done. But I ordered Even If It Hurts by Marnie Mann, because McKay said to read it and that it wrecked her, and it is a love triangle. It's kind of like a TJR book almost. She is in love with this guy in college,
and then they're only together in college, and they're only together for a semester. Then she forgets about him, falls in love with another guy, gets married to him after college, and then the guy from college shows up back in her life, and she has to choose one of them. And then this is the first book in the Kingmaker series by Sophie Lark. This is the sons of the mafia people in The Brutal Birthright, which I'm reading right now. And this book is a chunker. It's like 500 pages. So I need to get the rest of them before they go out of print. So that's what I'm going to do on my birthday vlog, probably in 2 weeks, is buy the rest of these. But I got this one on Pango, so good deal. But I definitely want to read this one super soon. I have the audio for it on Hoopla, so I'll probably start it next week, maybe? I don't know just yet. And then I have a big box in here that I need to go ship for Pango. Somebody bought like 5 books for my Pango yesterday. I'll link my Pango under here always. I sell books as I read them if I don't enjoy them. Like, I just read Dial A for Aunties, and I'm probably going to be getting rid of that soon. So, check out my Pango.
Hello, friends. Just got out of the shower. The air is on. Don't mind me. I'm a hot mess express, but I'm coming up here to say, did I think I was going to get a lot of reading done while my son was gone yesterday until 2, which I'm picking him up in about 30 minutes? Yes. Did I get any reading done? Yes. Did I get a lot done? No. I got 10% done of Caraval, so I'm 60% in, still really liking it. But just other stuff came up. My friends ended up coming over last night because I was free of Lincoln, and so it was just Eloise. And normally when my friends come over and Lincoln is home, he wants to play with them, and then I don't really get to see my friends as much because, like, we're having to deal with Lincoln at the same time. And so I said, y'all should come over when Lincoln's not here. And so they did, and we had a girls' night, and we just had wine and caught up and chatted, and it was really, really great. So I definitely needed that. I love those two so very much. And then this morning, I slept in a little, and then I've been cleaning, and then I had to re-record a bunch of harmonies. So I am directing a circus show. I've directed it for 2 years now. Well, this is the second year. The first year, it's called Circus Palooza, and this year, she wanted, my boss wanted half of the songs to be my originals because I write music. And I was like, yeah, sure, let's do it. And so I had to record harmonies for the two other vocalists, her and my friend, because they needed their harmonies so that they could practice. And I did it, but I recorded it so that it's like the guitar, the melody, and the harmony all on one track. And that worked for one of them, didn't work for the other. They were like, oh, I thought you were going to record the harmonies like separately by themselves. And I was like, oh, I didn't do that. So I had to spend this morning doing that one. That was not what I wanted to do. I wanted to like catch up on other books. But it's fine. I finished them. I'll probably insert a clip of me singing one of my songs in here somewhere because, you know, I worked a lot on these. I've spent like 16 hours, according to what I've been clocking in and out on like the past couple days, on recording all these harmonies and like filling out this little spreadsheet with like the pink is like when we have 3-part harmony and the blue is when we have 2-part harmony and orange is when we have unison harmony and like all that sort of stuff. So that's been fun. But I'm about to go pick up my son, and then I have to run a couple of errands with him. I have to go to the mail, the post office, to mail this Pango Books shipment that just, someone just bought for me. I need to post a couple more, books up on Pango, so I need to do that soon. And then I need to go to the library, and I need to return a bunch of books. I really need to be honest with myself about which books did I chuck out that I'm just not going to read right now. Now, it doesn't mean that I don't ever want to read them. I'm just not going to read them right now. So I'll probably take you on a journey of that and show you what I'm returning, what I'm keeping, and then we'll go. I'm going to keep Poppy War because I am reading this for a vlog soon. I'm keeping All Roads Lead Here because I'm reading it for a vlog right now. I'm going to keep Off the Deep End by Lucinda Berry and just read it soon because I love Lucinda Berry, so I like her thrillers. I'm keeping this because I'm reading it for a vlog soon. I picked this up thinking I was reading it for a vlog soon, and let's be honest, I'm not. So I'm going to return only when it's us by Chloe Leese, and I'll borrow it another day. I did want to read I'm Thinking of Ending Things by Ian Reid, and I might just keep that because honestly, this book is super short, and I read We Spread so quickly, I think I could probably get to this. I am going to keep The High Mountain Court for now because I am in a fantasy romance era, and I think I can get to this soon, and I'm definitely keeping How I'll Kill You because this is my mom's, like, one of her favorite books of the year. It's about 3 women serial killers, so I will keep that. So far, I'm keeping a lot. King Phantom, I'm reading it for a vlog. I know. I am returning The Deep by River Solomon. I thought I was going to read this for Once Upon a Readathon. I honestly have no desire, so I'm getting rid of that. I'm also returning They Drown Our Daughters. I was going to read that. Didn't get to it. Didn't really hear good reviews about it either, so you know it is what it is. I was going to read My Dearest Darkest, and it just didn't happen, so I'm going to return that. I'll get to it another day. I'm going to keep Lake's Edge because I do want to read that. I'm going to keep Fireborn because I'm reading that for a vlog. I was going to read The World Gives Way, but I just don't see myself reading that anytime soon. It's still on my TBR. I could check it out again in the future. And then I'm going to return Vespertine because I found Vespertine at Books A Million the other day for $5. Return In the Dream House by Carmen Marie Machado. I did want to read this, but I'm just not going to read this right now. Although I actually kind of want to keep it. It looks really good. You know what? I'm going to keep it. I'm going to read it soon. I'm prioritizing it. I am going to return House of Hunger. I'll read this another day. It's just, today's not that day. I'm going to return American Mermaid. I was going to read this for Once Upon a Readathon, and I didn't. Maybe I'll do another mermaid vlog at some point in the near distant future. I'm returning Aristotle and Dante. I also didn't get to a lot of my Pride Month videos. That's fine. I didn't get to Wilder Girls. I'm going to return that for now. I didn't get to Rules for Vanishing, and I'm going to return that for now. I'm going to keep Flower Heart. I do want to read that soon. I'm going to keep Gideon the Ninth because that took forever to get that book. I think I want to read Nevada, but not right now. And then I can finally return If We Were Villains because I read that for a vlog. I'm returning 10,000 Doors of January. I picked it up because I wanted to read it, but I would rather own this, so I'm just going to buy it myself. And then the last one I'm not going to take off the stack because it'll make everything else fall over. I think I'm going to keep Into the Drowning Deep for now. I just need to be convinced to read it. But I just have not wanted to read it yet. I don't know. So I'm returning all of this stack and this little stack. And then I'm keeping this big stack. So there we go.
Carval, then I'm gonna say what this one is about. If you don't, because you know,
you haven't read this yet and you want to not be spoiled, then don't look at this part. You can just watch the other part. But I'm going to have spoilery sections in here. Like, I'm just going to. So in this one, we follow. At the end of this one, what had happened is basically Scarlett ends up finding Donatella along with Julian. Basically, a lot of stuff goes down. Scarlett ends up winning the thing, and she ends up wishing for her sister to come back to life because apparently her sister died and Julian died. They both died, and she was only able to save one of them, so of course she's going to save her sister. And so she saves her sister, and then her sister ends up revealing, I was actually behind us coming to Carval. I reached out to him asking to help free us from our father because their father is insanely abusive, and he followed them to the land trying to take them back. And so she asked for help, and he said, I'll only help you if you do XYZ. And so she knew what was going to happen. And Julian is not actually dead because he is an actor on Carval. So he was just playing a part the whole time. And then you find out that he's actually Legend's brother. A lot of shit went down in this book, I'm telling you. So anyway, that was all very intriguing to me. But yet she took Julian back so quickly. And I just don't know if I would have. I just don't know. But that is what that is. And then in this one, they are doing another Carval game so soon after because the Empress of Elantine or something is having like a ball or something, and she wants to have like games there. And so in the very beginning, we're just dealing with that, like them getting ready to go to this ball. Like, not much has happened. I'm honestly only 45 pages in. I don't know how I forgot the main synopsis of this. The reason they're doing the second game is because at the very end of the first book, Donatella got a letter from a friend, and it doesn't say who, saying that you still owe me the true name of Legend, the Caraval Master, in return for finding your mother, because their mother disappeared 7 years ago, and they assumed that she just abandoned them or that she died and like left them, and apparently she is alive and has been captured. And so that, not by Shrek.
Shredder.
Oh, by Shred? I don't know who that is. But that is what's going on. So sorry that I forgot that pivotal plot point. But it's pretty good. Like I said, I'm really, really enjoying these books. But I feel like I did a terrible job explaining what happened in this book. And if you've read it, then you already know. And if you haven't, you're not watching this. But that's the end of the spoiler section. So I am going to continue on with Legendary. And we are going to see where we get.
Hey, howdy, hey. We are back from Aaron's grandma's, and I am trying to get some cleaning done, some reading done while baby girl's asleep and Lincoln is asleep because he missed his nap at grandma's, so he is dead asleep on the couch. I figured I'd show you the two library books I picked up yesterday and some more Pango mail that I got. And guys, I'm going crazy with Pango lately. Someone stop me. I feel like every time I update you, I'm showing you a book that I got. I don't know. I returned all those library books, like I said, and then I picked up two more, and that's it. I picked up Woman Eating by Claire Coda because I've always wanted to read this. I have almost bought this book like 20 times, and then I just kept not biting the bullet on it. So I figured I'd read it at the library, and if I really love it, then I will buy a copy for myself. And this is a vampire one about a woman that I don't think, she wants to live amongst humans, but she doesn't know how to do that while also being a vampire, I'm pretty sure. Like, I'm not entirely sure on that one. And then I picked up Fortuna Sworn by KJ Sutton, which I just saw somebody selling the first three books for like $30 on Pango, and that was very tempting. But I figured maybe I would read this one first and see what I thought of it. But I have been wanting to read this fantasy romance series for a while, and the cover is just very stunning to me. So we'll see where we get with that. And then I, on Pango, saw somebody selling Juniper Hill, Garnet Flats, and Jasper Vale for $10 a piece. And those are the next three books in the Edens series, which I have book one already, Indigo Ridge. I mean, just look how nice that looks all together. And so all I'm missing is I'm missing a Christmas novella that actually takes place before all of these. And then I'm missing one called The Legacy of the Edens that comes after the fourth book. Newest book, Crimson Ridge, I think just came out, and then the last one, Sable Peak, comes out in December. And so those covers are like a pinkish and a purple, and so I'm very excited to complete this series. Hopefully I will get to Juniper Hill sooner than later. I do need to do a refresher on like which brother and which sister is like each of these love stories are about, because I don't really remember all the characters from Indigo Ridge because there was a lot of them. So yeah, I need to get reacquainted on that, but I'm very excited with this. But I keep buying too much stuff because I just got the second book for Binding 13 by Chloe Walsh. I got Keeping 13 on Pango. I just picked up another one called Take It Back by Kia Abdullah because that's a thriller that I've been wanting to read for a long time. Like, people just keep posting stuff. I've been seeing stuff on Pango that I've been eyeing all day, and I'm like, Rainy, you gotta stop. You have a serious obsession. It is what it is. Okay. I am going to try and clean and get some reading done, and I'll come back to you with an update on Legendary because I want to make some serious progress in it today. Oh, I feel so alive.
reach out, reach out, reach out to the sky. I found my way, I found my way. I was in the dark against it all, but made it through the day, cause I found my way.
Hello friends, I feel like I have not been vlogging a lot on this. I don't know. It's been a crazy week. Let's just say it. Leave it at that. But I have updates for you. So I went to the mailbox. I got more mail, of course, and I got some annotating tabs from Shein. However, I'm confused, and I think this was like a China mess up because each one of these said that it was like $1,200 in the pack, and they were each like $1.50 a piece, and I was like, dang, all right, legit. This is not 1,200 pieces. Like, I ordered two of them because I was expecting to have 2,400, and I have 40. So it was like a 10 pack and a 10 pack. Don't know what happened there. I only paid like $3. So it's really just not that big of a loss. But yeah, that was a big miscommunication on my part. So I wouldn't recommend those. But I like the colors. I'll definitely annotate some book with this. Hopefully just a standalone and not a series, because otherwise I'm going to be screwed. I don't have more of those tabs. And then also my copy of Keeping 13 by Chloe Walsh came in today. I'm excited. I have the first book and the second book now in the Boys of Tommen series. However, they're like 600 pages. And look how tiny that font is. And the audiobooks are so long that you have to buy part one and part two for these. I have to spend 4 credits on this crap. So you better believe that once I actually spend the credits on these, that I'm going to be reading them right away. Because what book is going to be worth that to me? I don't know. I'm also organizing my shelves again because I still don't have room for all my books. But like, that's an everyday issue. I did fix this one a little bit. But you know. And then I ordered one more book. And it hadn't even said it had shipped yet. And then it said it was delivered today, and I'm like, what? And I look, it was picked up in North Carolina, and it was delivered in North Carolina. And I'm a little confused as to what happened. Not gonna lie. But it is what it is. I need to mail out some Pingo books tomorrow. But let's also do an update on Legendary, because I need to finish this bad boy tonight if I'm actually gonna finish finale and finish by Sunday, because it's Thursday night. I am currently on page 190. I am on night 2 of Caraval, so the games are always 5 days long, so that's where we're at. And I will say my thoughts before spoilers, but I'm gonna have a spoiler section because I can't not. Although, I will say this because I don't think this is a spoiler. If you are watching this vlog and you're wondering if you need to read the Caraval series before you jump into the Once Upon a Broken Heart series, I would argue yes, that they're interconnected. Now, I would say no in the sense that do you have to read no, not necessarily. But like, the whole premise of the first book in Once Upon a Broken Heart series is that the girl meets the Prince of Heart, Evangeline meets the Prince of Heart, and like gets 3 wishes in exchange for 3 kisses or something like that. And the Prince of Hearts is like the main character in book 2. So, Jax, the Prince of Heart. So I would say that that is enough interconnection that I'm glad I'm reading this first so that I have that backstory and I know a little bit about Jax and like who he is and how the Prince of Hearts works and all that sort of stuff. So I will say that. I'm very glad that I'm reading this first. So that's where I'm at. But I am still really, really loving this. This game is just so much fun. I'm loving getting more info on the world. I'm loving what this one is focusing on, which is a spoiler, so I can't say. But I'm just having a grand old time with this. Like, I am just loving this. I know I'm very late to the game in this, but I found someone on TikTok that like I follow that like reads a lot of fantasy books, and they were just starting to read this too. So it made me feel a little bit better. I'm not the only one lost in the sauce. And maybe a lot of people like me are trying to read this before the next books come out, which is understandable. So anyway, that's my non-spoilery update. So here's the spoiler update. So in this, Jax, the Prince of Heart, well, basically, their mom gave Tella a deck of cards before she like ran away or was captured, or we're still not really sure what happened to their mom. But she gave her a magical deck of cards, and they have pictures of like the fates on them. And the fates were, there's a lot of myths about the fates, that the fates were like people that had been cast away by a wicked old witch, or like they don't know what happened to the fates, or they were banished from this magic land. And there's lots of myths. Well, the Prince of Hearts, Jax, who is the heir to the Meridian throne, so he's the son of Queen Elantine, the reason they're having these Caraval games right now, is he is there, and he's there because Tella went to go play the games this time instead of Scarlet, and they said, well, we only have an invitation for Scarlet, you weren't invited. And so then Dante, one of the characters from the last book, who has always liked Tella, says, well, she's engaged to the heir of the throne. And then everyone's scared of her because the heir of the throne has, like, apparently murdered a lot of people to get to the throne, and, like, he's not actually the heir, and this is the Prince of Hearts, Jax. And so when he finds out that she's going around saying that she's his fiance, he decides, you're actually going to be my fiance, and you have to give me 2 pieces of information. And you find out that he was the friend at the end of the book that she was working with that needed to expose Legend and give him the name. It was Prince Jax, the fiance. Crazy. And now, he said, since you didn't bring it to me in time, you have to bring me Legend instead of just the name. I want you to bring me the man when you win. And he kisses her, and she feels like she's going to die because apparently he's famous as a fate for the kiss of death. When he kisses you, you die a slow and painful death. Except for he kissed her in a way that she's not going to die unless she doesn't complete what he said. And he'll kill her mom, too. And then he shows her a card of her mom. Apparently, she has been captured and kidnapped and put into a card for like 7 years. That's where she's been. And so there's a lot riding on the line for Tella to win this game. And so that is where we're at currently. And we are at the end of day one, and she is trying to win Carval so that she can, you know, bring Legend to Jax. So that's where we're at. So Jax is kind of an evil character. But I'm just loving it. I'm excited to see where we go with the Fates and, like, learn more about that. I'm just having the best time. I really am. So this was a long update. I'm sprinting right now with my friends Neva. I was about to say Waverly, but I changed my name on her sprints. I'm sprinting with my friends Neva and Amy over on Neva's channel. We have about 15 minutes left in the sprint, so I'm going to try and read a little bit more. And then I need to figure out what we're eating for dinner. And then I need to finish organizing my shelves. All right, here we go. Hello, friends. I'm terrible at updating. We know that. This week, it's been... I feel like I'm saying that every time, but it is what it is. It is Saturday. I have lots of things to update you about. I need to get a box for this book so I can mail it. I'm currently mailing another Pingo book right now. I'm sitting outside my circus studio because I'm about to go in for auditions. I am in charge of auditions for the show that I'm producing, so I have to watch auditions today. But I finished Legendary, and I am 25% into finale, and I need to finish this book today because this vlog comes up tomorrow. It's fine. It's fine. We're fine. I'm gonna do it. Okay, so let's do an update on Legendary. I finished. A lot of shit went down in that book. I also gave it a 4-star. I feel like this series is going to get a 4-star as a whole. Although this one I'm actually really enjoying, so this one might end up being a 5-star depending on how it goes, how it wraps up. But I'm really, really liking it. I just love the story. I just love the world. I'm just very much a fan. Stephanie Garber is a new fan favorite. I like her as an author. She's pretty good. But I had a lot of fun with it. The ending was like, the ending had a lot of shocking twists and stuff that like I should have expected because she kind of said it with like in the beginning, but it is what it is. It's neither here nor there. Now I am going to get into a spoiler section because I obviously can't talk about it. So the spoilers are, before I jump into spoilers, I will say the second book was from Donatella's perspective and the first book was from Scarlett's perspective. And everyone said the Scarlett's perspective was better, but I don't agree with that. I actually enjoyed Donatella's book better. So actually, I think I enjoyed the second book a little bit better. I might put it at like a 4.25 instead. I liked Donatella's perspective a lot better. I don't know. She was more interesting to me. I liked the whole story with like Prince of Hearts Jax and like Dante and like, I don't know. I just thought Scarlett was like whiny and annoying because she just wants to be with the fiance Nicholas Darcy, who like she's never met before. But like, why? I don't understand her. Now I'll jump into spoilers. Okay, so spoilers wise. I know that they had hinted at Dante being Legend, actually, but then as soon as she said that, she overheard Dante saying that he was Julian's brother, I was like, oh, it should have clicked for me. That meant he's Legend. But I still didn't get it until, like, literally at the end, he reveals he's Legend because they said that if she wins the game, the first person she'll see is Legend, and she saw Dante, and so he's Legend. And he fell in love with Donatella, like, the powerful Legend, the master of Carval, fell in love with Donatella. And actually saved her because at the end she wanted to save her mom, and she had this ring that her mom had given her, and the ring apparently opens this magical vault that has like the deck of cards with all the fates on them, and the only way to get into that vault is to sacrifice yourself, and so she would have to be put onto a card. So she decides to do that to save her mom, and then Legend decides, well, I don't want you to do that because I'm in love with you. So he decides to like free the fates in order to free Donatella. So he lets all these powerful fates back out into the world, and of course they're all asleep because they've been imprisoned for however many years, and so it's going to take them a while to get back to their full power. And so that's what happened with Legend. So he saved Donatella, but then he like
kisses her and then runs away from her. And then you don't know what happened until you find out, like, the Empress of Elantine, who was slowly dying, had finally died. But right before she did, her missing heir, apparently she had an heir to the throne that was missing, came back to claim his right to the throne. And it was Legend who's posing as Dante, pretending to be the heir to the throne so that he can be in charge of Elantine. And that was how it ended. It was wild. It's wild. It took me for a ride. I had a great time with it, like I said. I'm living, I'm loving, I'm laughing, I'm learning. So that is where we left off on Legendary. Spoilers are over. I think it's a fun time. And I actually would probably give that a 4.25 because I enjoyed it more than I enjoyed Carvel. And now we're in finale. And let me tell you, some stuff has gone down. Finale is just really good. I'm just enjoying this. I just keep saying I'm living my best life. It is spellbinding, as it says on the back. So let's jump into a little bit of spoiler stuff there. If you're with me, keep going. If not, you can go to my next update because I'm just going to give an update. So in this one, we are switching perspectives between Scarlet and Donatella. Although I would say the first like 100 pages so far have mainly been from Donatella's perspective. I think we've had 2 chapters from Scarlet, which doesn't bother me because I don't like Scarlet as much as I like Donatella. Scarlet is finally trying to meet Count Nicholas Darcy, her fiance. Like, I don't know why she wants to meet him, but whatever. But she still loves Julian, the guy from the first book. But she decides to have them go head to head against each other in like this battle where she decides what challenges they have to do. Whoever wins at the end gets her hand in marriage. I don't know why she's pulling that crap. Whatever. I don't care about that as much, that plot line as much. But Donatella, so their mom came out of the deck of cards and she has been basically comatose since the thing happened 2 months prior because she like needs to get her power back. And so finally she wakes up, she sees Donatella for like a second and then like drugs her and runs away because she says, I need to kill someone. So you find out that she went to go meet up with one of the Fates. You find out that it's the Fallen Star and that basically they used to have a relationship. And so she says, I still love you. And he says, well, you cursed me and put me in a card. And she says, well, I still want to be with you. And then while he's not looking, she stabs him and then he stabs her and they both end up dying. So her mother dies right in front of her and the Fallen Star guy, or no, they don't both die. She thinks he's gonna die, but Fates don't die. So then he stabs her. So she dies right in front of him and the Fallen Star guy runs away. And so she vows to kill the Fallen Star, which she already had to kill the Fallen Star because in order for Legend to get all of his full powers back and to get rid of the Fates, or to kill the Fates, because he wants to kill the Fates so they don't kill him, he has to kill the Fallen Star because he's the one that made all the Fates. And so if you kill the Fallen Star, then you can kill all the Fates one by one. And so Legend is trying to kill the Fallen Star, and Donatella is trying to kill the Fallen Star because it killed their mother. Although now she's also trying to find one of the Fates that like goes back and travels through time so that she can just travel back through time and stop her mother from dying and have her make a different choice. So there's like all this crap going on. And so that's where we are at in this book. And so I am 25% in, like I said. I am loving it. I can't wait to finish it. Will I finish it tonight? Yes, I have to. I need to. I want to. And then I can start the other series. So I'm going to go in now. It's really hot in my car.
Hi, hello, hey. Living our best life. Just took a shower. Ready to rock and roll. Figured I'd come up to you with some book mail and give you the final update. It is Sunday afternoon. Normally, I like to schedule my vlogs for 10 o'clock. But you're getting this in the afternoon because I had to finish finale first. So before I tell you my update on that, let's just show you the books that I got the other day. I got another book off of Pango, Take It Back by Kia Abdullah. This is the one that like was lost in North Carolina. It wasn't actually. They just marked it wrong. So I have heard Haley Hughes talk about this one a lot, which is why I picked it up. I'm not really in a thriller era right now, but this was like $5. So when I get to my thriller era again, I will get that. And then I finally picked up this book because the audiobook finally became available to me, like 40th in line, and I didn't want to wait any longer. And so that is Yellowface by R.F. Kuang. And we are actually going to be starting that for next week's vlog. So this is like, you'll see me vlogging this one in next week's because I am so excited to read this. You'll also see me vlogging The Boyfriend Candidate by Ashley Winstead. Now this I looked for like 2 months ago at Books A Million and it said limited quantity, which means normally only one is left, and I could not find it. Someone had picked it up and put it in the wrong spot. And then lo and behold, it was there today. It was the last one. So this is, I can't tell. I don't know if this is a sequel to Fool Me Once. Like if this is the same, if this is her friend, I need to look and see if they're actually related or if this is just another romance, but it is another political romance. It is another political romance. And so I am excited to get to this because the audiobook for this also came in. So I have to read these both this week. And then I'm going to read this in August with a bunch of my friends because Margaret from The Word Nerd told me that I should read this because it's her favorite book, and that's Little Thieves by Margaret Owens. I'm very excited to read this. I know nothing about it, but it looked cute. And that's all you really need to buy a book. Okay, now let me close up this vlog by finishing with finale. It was a 4-star, so I'll add a 4, a 4.5, and a 4. I liked this. I feel like there was a lot of info dumping going on towards the end and a lot of stuff that, like, had to happen quickly to, like, have the ending that, like, it needed. But I still really enjoyed it. Too much went on for me to try to explain this. I might do a little spoiler section for this, but I did read, like, half of this morning because, like, I just didn't have time to read yesterday, and I needed to get this girl done! But we are finished with the whole Caraval series. I really enjoyed the way that it wrapped up. I think it was a cute little fantasy romance for YA. I thought it was perfectly fun. I cannot wait to move on to the Once Upon a Broken Heart trilogy. But this was so cute. I'm so glad I finally read it. It's been sitting on my shelves for 5 ever. So now I can say that I finished it and I can check another series off in our series declutter. Because if you watched episode 1 is where I actually made the series chart. And this is our official, well, that was actually episode 0. This is episode 1 where we finally marked a series off the list. And I can say that I finished the whole series, started and finished in this vlog. Woo, yay, go me. Okay, let's do a brief little spoiler section. And then we're done. Okay, spoiler section for finale. Honestly, too much went on. At one point, she was married to the Prince of Hearts, like Jax, because apparently when she asked him to take away her grief, he, like, entwined their souls together, but he allowed her to, like, disconnect himself from her so that she could love him for who he is. And, like, she's, I don't know if I ever mentioned this, but the Prince of Hearts is, like, he's not allowed to love anyone, or his weakness is loving someone, and he loved Donatella. But she's also in love with Legend, but Legend is in love with immortality and he wants her to become an immortal so that they can be immortal together, but then she doesn't want to be an immortal. And so there's this whole love triangle going on there the whole time. And then you find out that Scarlet and Donatella have different dads and that Scarlet's dad is actually, like, the fallen star, the person they're trying to kill, that apparently he was in love with her mom, Paloma, who's actually called Paradise. And that they were gonna have a baby together, but then Scarlet has to go back in the future and tell her not to marry him and to marry the terrible abusive father of theirs because she needs to steal her dress so that she can pretend to be her mother in the real world so that she can convince the fallen star that she's back just enough to weaken him enough to, like, kill him. And then that is kind of what happens. And so I wonder if she hadn't gone back in the future, of, like, if she was always supposed to have gone back in the future. Probably, because you know that's how those time travel things work. And so then they kill the fallen star, and he dies, and then since he was pretending to be the heir to the throne, and that he was king, and that she was the princess, she is now officially the princess, or now the empress to the throne, because she's coronated at the end, Queen Scarlet. And then we have that Legend decides to give up his immortality powers for Donatella because he wants to be with her forever, and he finally admits that he loves her because immortals can't love, and so he becomes not immortal anymore. And then him and Donatella go off on an adventure somewhere, and that is the end of this book. Like I said, it got a little crazy. There was a lot of stuff that went on. I missed so much stuff in this spoiler section that I was supposed to alert you about, but it's okay. I had a great time with this. So now that we're done with spoilers, I will say overall, I very much enjoyed this series. Like I said, I gave it a 4, a 4.5, and a 4. None of them were, like, 5 wow factor, but, like, I really enjoyed my time with this. I'm so glad this was the first series to start kicking off for this series. I am going to be going through series a lot, so you will see a lot of these series declutter episodes. But with that being said, I need to do my hair, let my sister go home because she slept over last night, and then we will start up with the weekly vlog where you will see me start to read Yellowface. All right, guys, I'll see you in the next video. Bye. If I only knew how to make it true.